You're watching Keystone Science, and in today's episode, we're going to show you how to use electromagnetism to make your very own speaker. As you can see here, I have a compass. And as you can see, when I bring a big magnet near the compass will point towards the magnet. Similarly, watch what happens as I run electricity through this wire next to the compass. As you can see, the needle moves a little bit whenever I connect and disconnect the power from the wire. Now I have a bunch of wire coiled around something metal, and watch what happens is now when I connect the power. As you can see, the needle moves much more noticeably. This is because as electrons are flowing through a wire, they create a magnetic field around them. So independently, a single bit of wire like this would have a small magnetic field, as we saw with the compass needle moving slightly. So when we take some of these wires and wind them into a coil such as this, all the magnetic fields are additive together, and together they form a stronger magnetic field around the coil. The speaker is really just two simple components. We have a magnet down here at the base, and right inside we have a coil of copper wire that's attached to these two wires going out here on either end. So with this, we have the electricity running through the coil, thus making a magnetic field, which makes the coil go up and down relative to the magnet, making the speaker net move up and down as well, creating sound. I'm going to be using these disc ceramic magnets that I salvaged out of a magnetron from a microwave. However, you can really use any decently strong magnet you have lying around to achieve this. Now I'm going to take some paper like this, and I'm going to cut out a strip of paper that's a little bit taller than the magnet itself. And now that I have that strip of paper, I'm going to put it alongside the magnet and wrap it around. And then when you have the paper wrapped around the magnet like this, take a small piece of tape and use it to hold your position. Make sure that you made the paper loose enough so that it can easily slide off and on of the magnet like this. Next, we're going to need some magnet wire such as this. Magnet wire is basically copper wire with a thin enamel around it, so that if I were to touch it to itself, it wouldn't conduct. However, there's no real need to go out and buy magnet wire for this project, because pretty much in every circuit you can salvage it. Whether it's on inductors, transformers, or even motors like this, that's all magnet wire, and you could uncoil it from the spindle. Leave a decent trail off of wire going off so that we can connect it later, and go ahead and wind the wire in a coil going up the side of the paper. And there we go, as you can see, I have some wire wrapped around the piece of paper. Be sure that your coil can still slide freely over the magnet. Since this wire is enameled, we need to sand away some of the enameling so that it can conduct. The next thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and take something circular and trace around it. And now go ahead and cut out around that circle. Now that we have that done, go ahead and put one slit going into the middle like that. And then now that we have that slit, you can fold it up like this, and it'll make a cone. When you have the cone size you want, put a piece of tape onto it so that it holds its shape. Now going back to this, I'm going to cut it down just a little bit. Now go ahead and use some tape to attach the cone to your coil. And now you should have something that looks pretty similar to this. Okay, so now I have an auxiliary cord plugged into this iPad. And on this other end, I have alligator clips, one connecting it to the bottom pin, one connecting it to the one two pins up. This way the audio signal will be going from the iPad over to the end here, and then I'm going to be tapping it off to go over here to my speaker. I made these little springy things out of some pretty thick paper, and they act to hold up the coil in the optimum position. Now that we have the speaker connected up, you can see that as the electrical signals go through the coil, it jumps up and down from that magnet. This makes this cone jump up and down, creating the sound that you hear. Despite the speaker being put together really crudely, it still produces quite an audible sound. So now hearing this, let's compare this speaker to a real one. As you can hear, the real speaker is much louder. This is for a number of reasons. First off, the magnet placement inside here is better. Second off, for this speaker, they use much thinner wire and many more turns on the coil. And this speaker is going to be a great way for you to show your friends how one actually works. So now you know how a speaker works and how you can build your very own. Thank you so much for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, I'd appreciate it if you'd hit the thumbs up button down below. And if you'd like to see our weekly video show up in your subscription newsfeed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. I'll see you next time. Be safe and have a wonderful day. You're watching Keystone Science, and in today's episode, we're going to show you how to turn an old CRT TV into your very own portable Jacob's ladder.